Hey, this is DJ from DJ's Trains on YouTube. I'm going to show you how easy it is to build a kit. We're going to start with the N-Scale George Roberts printing. This is from Walther's. It's a good kit. The first thing I do is I cut all the main walls out, and then I prime them. And by priming, I'm just using just white primer. You're not painting. I did this outside. I hit it with light coats of primer to get the paint to stick. If you don't, the paint doesn't stick well. Now, I use photographs because I'm not an artist. These are just simple 50 cent to a dollar acrylic paints I got at Walmart. And so what I'm going to do is I'm using this photograph of the real place, and I'm looking at things like, okay, so the upper brick's this color, the lower brick's this color, it's weathered here, just for ideas. I'm not modeling this exact. This is where people like drive themselves nuts, and I used to drive myself nuts thinking it had to be exact. It doesn't. Now, I add a little bit of water. When painting with a brush, you're going to find out that sometimes the paint could be either like too thick or too thin. It's kind of trial and error. Now, if I was to paint this whole thing in real time, it would take so long you wouldn't watch this whole video. So I'm going to speed it up. And I just want to show you that the first coat, I'm going to do this a little sloppy. And I'm going to show you why. Because I don't want you to be intimidated by painting. Because I don't mask. I do not mask whenever I paint. If I had to mask all the concrete, it just wouldn't be worth my time. So acrylics are cool because watch this. So I go a little sloppy, and the brick is lower than the concrete. And look, you can just wipe off the excess paint that's on the concrete. Acrylic paints, you can paint over and over and over. That's what I love about it. So we're going to speed this up. This is going to be my first coat. And really, I'm just trying to get a first coat onto the brick. So it doesn't look too bad for the first coat. Then I went back and I looked at that photo. I'm like, oh yeah, that's right. The whole bottom row of brick, the owner painted red. And then the concrete, he painted white. Now the one side wall, I left the terracotta color. But the other walls I painted red. Is it time consuming? Yeah. Not going to lie. It could be kind of time consuming. So I'm looking at the photo and I see, okay, there's like white discoloration up here. And it's also like black and gray. And some areas is rust colored. That's why I use photos. I don't have an imagination. I am not an artist. I am a duplicator. It's going to look so good when I paint the concrete right after this quick break. Hey, I'll get right back to the video in just a minute, but we're getting close to Christmas, and I know you don't want to be at the malls either. All right, so when this video's over, go on ridge.com/DJ's Trains. That's my link, ridge.com/DJ's Trains. It's the holiday sale between now and December 20th, so you got to hurry. When you enter your email address, you get the chance to win a Ridge Bundle. No purchase necessary, up to $4,000 worth in this Ridge Bundle. It's awesome. The holiday sale, you're gonna save up to like 40% off a lot of their stuff. And they got new stuff. There's so much stuff I can't even tell you in this quick video, but I'll show you three new colors. Sea glass, lavender, eucalyptus. And you wanna see my personal wallet? I think I showed you this last time, but still my wallet. Look at that. This is the hyper lime because I'm not losing this. It's dark all the time outside. And I'm not dropping and losing it. So this is my wallet. It's my actual wallet. There's my cash. If I need anything, I just press on the indent and pull it. There's my insurance card.
driver's license, credit card. That's all you need. This is my key case. Look, there's my front door key. They got rings. This is my Alpine Navy. Look at that. That's so nice. And since I can't wear this at work, it also comes with a silicone band. But you got to go on ridge.com/DJ's trains between now and December 20th. Give them your email address for a free chance to win a Ridge bundle worth $4,000. It's all good stuff. Oh, and I got some new stuff. I just saw it last night. I was looking at their website last night. Wait till you see some of the new products. I'm not gonna tell you right now, but you got to look, because I was like, oh man, this is really cool. I want this too. So go on ridge.com/DJ's trains. And now watch the rest of this video, because it's really good and you're really going to be happy with the results.
So painting the concrete is so much easier than you'd imagine. Because it's raised, it was really easy for me to paint the concrete without touching the red brick. I used a smaller tip paintbrush to do the window ledges. Now, is this looking good? Yes. If I can do this, you can do this, I promise. Easy weathering. I'm going to do all the walls like this. I got water and a little bit of that black acrylic paint. I'm making a nice mixture. Some people use rubbing alcohol. I'm just using water for this one. I'm going to lightly go over all the brick and the concrete. It's going to kind of mute the brightness of the colors. It gives just very subtle weathering. If you want to go darker, you can go darker. The windows are great. I just thought that I wanted them to look a little bit more weathered, and so I took it outside and I sprayed it with some spray paint. So when I went to flip it over, I'm like, oh crap, there's brick up here I didn't even see, so I'm going to paint that later. I cut the windows out. Make sure you have a sharp knife. And I use my plastic glue. It's the same glue I'm using for the walls. I glue my windows in. There's a variety of decals and signs that you can use. Decaling isn't my strong point, but I'm going to give it a shot. I liked the Blair line, and I'll show you how I do that. But first, I have to spray everything with that clear. Okay, now speaking of clear, look at the Walther's windows. Those are nice. They have like a haze to them. We'll get to that in a minute. But first, I'm going to do standard decaling with a micro set. There's a little bit of water, put the decal in. And there's probably better videos on YouTube about decaling. It's not my strong point, but I pulled it off. That's why I'm not going to cover it too much. There's better videos out there. Just dab up the excess water. The Blair line decals are already like pre-cut. I thought they're pretty nice to match the graffiti that's on the prototype building. Looking good, right? All right. My only complaint, I did put together the steps for the fire escape. It wasn't that easy. At least I'm honest. All right, so here is, after I glued the windows in, you can use the plastic glue or window, like the tester's window maker. Now, I tried something different. I tried spray painting black some of the windows. I thought that it would help prevent like the light from showing through all the windows whenever I lighted this building. Didn't work out as great as I had hoped. But everything's trial and error. But this is what we've done so far. And it looks pretty good, right? I'm pretty happy with it. Now, personally, I always like to not build all four walls because that back wall won't be visible. So I just used plain styrene and then some brick sheet. And I made a replacement wall. I'm not going to really go over it in this video. You're not going to see it anyway. This is what you're going to see. Look, it looks great, doesn't it? And if I can do this, you can do this. and we'll do the roof later. But I at least wanted to show you how, with no experience, you can make a pretty cool kit. That looks pretty good. So subscribe to my channel, DJ's Trains. I have a lot of videos about layout building and scratch building. Because in a lot of cases, I don't use all four walls. And I scratch build, and I'll have links to a couple of those videos where I scratch build other walls. And I save all the parts that I didn't use for future builds. Hey, if you enjoyed this video, consider joining my Patreon. Now, the Patreon link is in this video's description. When you join Patreon, every month you get a behind-the-scenes video. There's no ads. And that is going to have maybe footage that I haven't released yet, scoop on upcoming videos, even stories about being an engineer. A lot of stuff that you may not see on my regular YouTube channel. That's all in the behind-the-scenes. Other levels include everything from help with your track plan or layout design, personal videos if you like, to Zoom calls. We do 40-minute long Zoom calls face-to-face. We could talk about everything from model railroading to me helping you out with understanding how the real railroad works. So once again, check out the Patreon. And at this time, I want to thank some of my newest Patreons, Jake Atkinson, Atlas171, and SD. I appreciate all the support, and I'll talk to you guys soon.